This was a 4-2 game when the third period began, and Kyle Palmieri. Bryce.
We were talking about this on air live when Kyle made a spectacular individual effort to go on a backhand. We saw two of those backhand wrap goals, you know, this game. And just when your veterans step up like this, you give your team a chance to get back in this game.
50-50 puck battle.
Yes.
Face off. Nobody wins it cleanly. He outworks England, goes to the net. Your top player, one of your top, or your top goal scorer, comes through at a big time.
Oh, and that's huge. And that just sparked momentum. As I was talking about, you got to manage the clock now. And then Cini. I love this kid. 156 pounds, and he's not afraid to go through anybody.
We give him 167.
Okay, 167. Yeah, what changes it on? But look at the tenacity, the effort, going to the hard areas, and you get rewarded. And this was just nice to see the Devils get some of this luck, because mm-hmm. you need this when you're going through a situation like the Devils have been going through.
Or something goes your way finally. Yes, they got some breaks in this game. They worked hard, created a lot, outplayed the Vegas Golden Knights for a lot of this game. And there's the game winner in overtime, and a terrific effort. Sammy Vatanen gets to the Heischer. Now, this is a broken play, but Johansson's right in position. We haven't seen that. A lot of the times, the way this season has gone, Vegas would be going the other way 2-1, right? Well, that puck happens to carry him right to Johansson. He makes a terrific play and a great effort by Nico Heischer as he's going to the ice, staying with that puck and putting it home. This is a big, big win for these guys and a big win for their mentality.
When the game got to be 4-3, that's the point Keith Kincaid became the goaltender of record. He gets the win, his 11th tonight. Bryce, I want to take this back to the interview that you and Erica did with Ray before the game.
Yep.
One of the things that I thought was under the radar in that interview, he referenced Marc-Andre Fleury at a time when he was struggling, and he was yanked from the net, Kenny, if you remember, in the 2013 playoffs against the Islanders, at a point in his career where he looked lost. From that point moving forward, two more times he'd call himself a Stanley Cup champion, and here he is today winning games at a rate better than anybody else. There's this temptation to wave a red flag on Corey Schneider, but the Devils aren't going to do that. This is his hour of need, obviously, but maybe this in some way even lifts Corey up a little bit. His teammates bailed him out tonight.
They sure did, and you face adversity, different parts in your career. We all had adversity, and right now Corey's going through the toughest part of his career. And so he's only going to get stronger from it. And now it's really going to be, what are the Devils going to do? Are they going to go right back to him tomorrow? Right, get him right back in there, put him between the pipes? Or are they going to wait a game or so? But the thing is like, Marc-Andre Fleury, that was a great reference by Ray Sherrill. You never know what's going to happen. Pekka Rinne had the same type of surgery. He won a Vezina after that. Tim Thomas, I go back, he had the same surgery. Next year, he ends up winning the Stanley Cup. So you goalies, even when they're older, can come back from that surgery. Now it's just the confidence and the mental part of the game, which it's tough. You know, Corey's going to have to fight it. It's you know, the team is trying their best. And look, sometimes it just doesn't go the way you want it to go, and there's nothing you can do. How many goals has Corey allowed that his own teammates have put in? 4 or 5 goals. I've never seen that in that short of a span, in any part of a span of hockey. That many goals where you're flat out, guys are shooting the pucks in, they're going off guys' gloves in, you know, they're going off you. Like, so I just, you look at that and you say, you know what, some of this is just out of his control. It doesn't matter what he does.
I don't know where this is going, Bryce, as far as can Corey gain his confidence again? Can he get a win? Can he stop the puck? That's the key. You have to make big saves in this league, and I think it was important for the Devils to come back, certainly, and make him feel a little bit better. And great references. You're right. We've heard that from general manager Ray Sherrill, so he has experience with other guys. Doesn't mean Corey's going to come out of this and become the same Corey Schneider of old, but there's a chance. That's the point. Marc-Andre Fleury, at that point, what you guys are referencing to, could not stop a beach ball, and he looked lost. Remember?
Yeah.
All of a sudden, he bounced back. He's been one of the great goaltenders in the National Hockey League, but he battled through that adversity. We hope that for Corey. He's a terrific character guy.
Handled
so well.
He cares
so much, but coaches have decisions to make. That makes it difficult. About every night, you want to win hockey games, no matter where you are, and still a lot of hockey left. That, you know, sometimes maybe they feel, can we afford to put him in to find his game? But let's hope he can. And this might be a stepping stone as far as the Devils bailing him out, like you mentioned.